Hi, I'm Jamie Edwards. I got Robert Pattinson with me now. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm really good. I kind of feel sad.
Why?
It's the end.
Oh. I was like, don't be sad.
Yeah, I'm sad that I'm interviewing you. Really, the envy of every girl really in my sad office. My girlfriend hasn't stopped going on about it.
I would like it if you were just like, I'm just really sad today. I'm just going through a rough time.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm trying to move back. Listen, we should just get you to let anybody who doesn't know the story for this, just tell us how this film picks up from the last one.
I think it basically begins the second... Well, anyone who knows anything about the films, Bella is a young girl who fell in love with a vampire 4 movies ago. And now she wakes up and she has been turned into a vampire. And she starts experiencing her new life, and she has a, you know, she wants to drink people's blood and stuff. And she also has a child who is growing at a very alarming rate. And her and Edward have to kind of adapt to their new life together.
You summed that up really well.
Really? I was like, is this even the movie? What am I even talking about?
I love the fact she's a vampire, she'd want to drink blood. You know, it's so blasé about, yeah.
You got to kind of, yeah.
It's been quite a journey for you, actually, hasn't it? I mean, the whole saga. Have you had one moment from the whole lot that's not blood, is it?
This is blood, yes.
Okay, good. Have you had one moment from the whole saga that you think, oh, that's my moment, that's the one I'll remember?
I quite like in the second movie that we did, the scene in Italy where I had to come out into this courtyard and there's like 5,000 people watching with my shirt off and just walk into the sunlight as I was trying to kill myself as a vampire going into the sun. And it was one of the most embarrassing things I've ever had to do in my life, and I'll never forget it.
How do you think Taylor's felt?
But Taylor's all like buff and stuff. I had sprayed on abs. Like, I mean, 3,000 people could see the makeup artist doing it. And I'm like, don't worry, it's going to be fixed in post.
What about the one that you'll be happy to you know, well, saying that, that's probably what you're happy to forget as well.
Happy to forget. I had to put some cream cheese and strawberry jam on a 3-week-old baby for the last one. And I think that's actually illegal. But somehow they got away with it. There's little loopholes in making movies. You can just put cheese on babies' heads.
Why
not? No one blames you. It's one thing my kid, more obviously.
The one thing that you will have to keep, it's going to stick with you, it's the nickname.
Yeah, I've got to get rid of that somehow.
R Patz.
I know. It's literally like... It's like, do you know when people take the mick out of you in school? And they're just like, how did you end up with this name, Gub? I prefer it if people just called me something totally random, like David or something. You just can't get away from people calling you David or just random names. David or Frank. I don't know.
From now on, you will be Frank to me. the one thing I sort of wanted to ask you as well is when I first interviewed you, and it was for the first film, I can remember you saying, "No, it's fine, I can still go into Tesco, I still go and buy my, you know, my shopping." Surely that has now changed for you. You can't just go into Tesco.
It's funny, the last time I went into, well, maybe not the last time, but one of the last times, I was shooting a movie in London, and I went into Tesco to buy some more underpants. And it wasn't Tesco, it was an M&S. And I walked in, I was thinking, like, wow, this is so crazy. I'm just walking around buying some underpants, and no one's even noticing I'm there. And I was with like, my friend, and I was like, this would be really embarrassing, though, if somebody photographed. Because sure enough, there was someone about 10 feet away from me photographing me. And it looks very embarrassing, browsing through the underpants section and giggling like little schoolgirls. But then M&S gave me a bunch of free underpants, which was great. And told me that they designed a pair of underpants, I'm not entirely sure, after my underpants or just after something. I don't know, they told me something. I don't know if they're still stocked anymore. Limited edition.
Boxers or briefs?
I actually just changed back to boxers.
Okay, good to know. There you go.
Briefs are old news.
You heard it here first. Listen, congratulations on this film and the whole series. You've converted me. I'm a try-hard. my house is a try-hard family, and we absolutely love it. So well done, mate.
Nice. Thanks very much.
Cheers. Cool. Thank you.